I was watching a video the other day on personal branding on YouTube, and after I watched the video, I said to myself, is that bad advice or is that really bad advice? I was so shocked by how bad the advice was. You see, most of these so-called personal branding experts, most of them are not qualified to teach personal branding because most of them have never built a strong personal brand, right? They're just talking about theories and ideas, but they actually have not done it themselves. So they're not qualified to teach that. And I thought to myself, you know what? Why don't I share some of my personal branding strategy and tips with you who are fans of my work? Now, when it comes to personal branding, you have to understand this, that when it comes to personal branding, it doesn't mean that you need to have a million followers on social media. That's what makes you a personal brand. That's not true. You and I, we all have a personal brand. You have a personal brand and I have a personal brand. Nothing more than your reputation. I want you to think about your personal brand equals your personal reputation. And you and I, we have a reputation right now. If I was to talk to some of your friends and I would ask them, hey, what do you think of you? What words would come to mind? In fact, let's do this. Comment below. If I was to talk to 5 of your closest friends right now, and I asked them to use 3 words to describe you, what words would come to mind? Would they say something like dependable, honest, hardworking, good work ethics, smart, intelligent, go-getters? What would they say about you? Or do you have a not so good personal brand, like not so good reputation? He likes to drink, she likes to party, right? Flaky, disorganized, late, dysfunctional, procrastinate. What word would come to mind? Go, comment below. Be honest. What would they say about you? 3 words. And then I want you to ask yourself, also comment below, what words that they're saying about you that maybe you don't want them to say about you, what 3 words you would like them to say about you? You would want them to say, maybe you're not quite there yet, but you want them to say these things about you. Comment below, 3 words. That's your personal brand. What do you want to be known for? The human mind, it's very, very simple. We can actually store so many thoughts in our minds when it comes to a person or when it comes to a personal brand. Whenever someone sees you, a few words always come to mind. You want those words to be positive and not negative. You want those words to help you to further whatever your goals might be, right? You want those words, you want to be associated with those powerful, positive words. Because people buy people. People buy from those who they like, know, and trust. And that's what makes a personal brand so powerful. Because you think about it, there's so much noise in the marketplace. There's a lot of noise in the marketplace. How do you stand out? If let's say you are a hairstylist, you are a plumber, you are an insurance agent, you're a mortgage broker, you're a realtor, whatever services that you provide, there are a lot of people who provide very, very similar services. Now you could say, oh, I've got more experience, I care about my customers, I do a better job, I have more expertise, all that is good. But it's very, very difficult to differentiate you from everybody else. But you are special, you are unique. There's only one of you in this whole world. There's only one of you, there's only one of Dan Lok. So how do you use that? How do you build your business around your personal brand? If people buy people, whenever you put a face to your brand, that adds a lot of credibility. Because you think about the consumers. Now they're not looking at just a CEO of this logo, right? It's not a faceless company anymore. There's a face behind the brand that, you know what? I know what the leader, what the CEO looks like. Just like when you buy from me, you can see, you know what I look like. You know what my wife looks like. You know what my mom looks like. You know what my team looks like. You know what my house looks like. You know what my car looks like. You know what I like. You know what I don't like. You know what are my philosophies. You know what I stand for, what I'm against. You know a lot of things about me if you follow my work. You see, when people know that about you, that creates a lot of trust. It's being transparent versus, oh, he is just a product. Well, who's behind this product? I don't know. What's this product about? I don't know. What's the vision for this product? I don't know. Exactly what does it do? I don't really know either. Well, that becomes very difficult to sell and market. Versus when you are transparent, when you have a strong personal brand around what you do, and notice what you sell might change. The product might change. The service might change. The program might change. Look at your career. Put in a comment. How many of you have changed different careers in your life? Maybe you were doing one thing and now you're doing something else. And after a few years, you're doing something else. What you do might change. But if your personal brand is consistent and if you know what to do, that is one of the most powerful, powerful things that you can do in business to make yourself stand out, to cut through the noise. Now, if you want to know how I use YouTube, which I believe is the number one most powerful platform to build your personal brand. If you want to know how I use YouTube to go from a successful entrepreneur to a global personal brand with millions and millions of followers and fans around the world, I'm conducting a special class that shows you exactly how I did that. Go ahead, click the link somewhere here or up above and join me for this special masterclass on how I've used YouTube to become a global personal brand. Go ahead. I'll see you in class.